Well, those images of Julia Gillard falling on her way to a press conference in India today may have overshadowed some of her mission to build Australia's relationship with the country. But just why is this visit so important? Well, bilateral trade between India and Australia is worth almost $18 billion to us. Ms. Gillard has used her first visit to begin uranium sale talks and promote greater cultural links between the two countries. But possibly her most important meeting will come in just a few hours' time. She'll meet with Sonia Gandhi of the Gandhi dynasty and one of India's most powerful female political personalities. As Prime Minister and Indian Congress Party leader, both have succeeded in industries dominated by men. Sonia Gandhi's husband, Rajiv, was the Prime Minister of India before he was assassinated in 1991. Now, since then, the Italian-born politician has made her own mark, even turning down the position of Prime Minister. She is widely regarded as the de facto ruler of India. Well, our political editor, Hugh Riminton, is travelling with the Prime Minister. He's in Delhi for us tonight. Hugh, obviously this is the business end of the trip. Julia Gillard's about to sit down with the Indian Prime Minister. What's the specifics of what they've got to get through?
Well, they certainly will, Hamish. This is a relationship that has a lot of room to grow on a lot of fronts. In terms of our economic partnership, it has increased 100-fold in terms of two-way trade in just the last 10 years. Now, the Prime Minister has set the goal of doubling our trade again by 2015. It's a tall order, but it shows the level of ambition that the Prime Minister has for our relationship with India. There's also defence. Now, Australia doesn't want to shout this from the rooftops, but it is a reality that in a strategic sense, India is seen as a long-term counterweight to the rise of China. So we have a lot of interest in defence cooperation with India. We have a lot of counter-terrorism cooperation scope with India, given that India, like Australia, like so many other parts of the world, have been subject to Islamist terrorism in the past. There's a lot that we can learn from each other. And then, of course, there's the thorny issue of uranium. It has been a big event for both countries to agree to start selling Australian uranium to the Indians. But there is a long way to go yet before we have the safety agreements in place so that Australia can be satisfied that the uranium we do sell to them is going entirely to peaceful purposes.
Hugh, obviously the Prime Minister had nice things to say about India. That's the way these things work. Does that necessarily mean a fundamental shift, move forward in this relationship?
There is something very fundamental that's taking place. In her speech today, the Prime Minister says that New Delhi must be seen as a forefront capital for us, and she named the others in the forefront: Washington, Beijing, Tokyo, Seoul, and Jakarta. No mention of London. Britain, it seems, is being airbrushed out of our future. It's no longer in the forefront. Here's how she responded to a question about Britain's place in our lives when she was asked about it a little earlier today.
We'll always have the bonds of history with the United Kingdom and a shared outlook on the world. Obviously, Australia's history and the history of the UK are intertwined, and so that is a very special relationship for us. But in the modern age, when we look at our economy, when we look at our strategic interests in our region of the world, it makes sense for us to look to the US, to China, to Japan, Indonesia, Korea, and India.
That's the big picture stuff, Hugh. The trivial, how's the PM doing after the fall?
Well, she seems to be fine. You know, she fell. It was an undignified moment, I suppose, but she certainly never really lost her dignity. She was quickly back onto her feet, back with her shoe on. She limped for a couple of steps, but she says she's fine, and I've seen her since. She seems to be walking about and be quite relaxed about it. It is the nature of the television YouTube world. People over here might be able to see her speeches to Parliament. Everyone in the world will see her take a stumble as she was walking there from Mahatma Gandhi's cremation site, where she laid a wreath. But I think probably there is more sympathy out there for her after an event like that, and particularly given that she took it in such good humour.
No stumbling from you as always, Hugh Riminton. Thanks very much.
OK, Hamish. Thank you.